Now, days after a U.S. police officer was acquitted of all charges in the shooting death of a black motorist, investigators have released a dashboard camera video of the incident. The video shows the officer, Geronimo Yanez, shooting Philando Castile 7 times in front of his girlfriend and a child in the back seat. Paul Chaderjian reports.
It began as a routine traffic stop.
We have to board you, your brake lights are out. So you only have one active brake light, and that's going to be your passenger side one, your third brake light, which is up here on top.
But this newly released video from police shows how quickly the situation took a dangerous turn for Minnesota motorist Philando Castile.
Sir, I have to tell you, I do have a firearm on me.
Don't reach for it, then. Don't pull it out.
We spoke to a former prosecutor about the video. She called it disturbing, saying it was clear that Castile informed the officer that he was in possession of a legal firearm.
One thing that it suggests is that the officer may have taken those actions because Castile was black. It is highly unlikely that somebody would warn an officer that he was armed before shooting that officer.
He killed my boy. He's licensed, he's carried.
The aftermath of the shooting was streamed live on Facebook by the victim's girlfriend, who was sitting in the passenger seat.
Let the officer know.
It was viewed by millions around the world. The dashcam video was shown at the officer's manslaughter trial.
And the officer just shot him in his arm. We're waiting for a back. I will, sir. No worries. I will.
Geronimo Yanez was acquitted, but was also fired by the police force. In a statement on Tuesday, the lawyer for Castile's girlfriend, Diamond Reynolds, says they are exploring new steps in light of what he called compelling evidence of Officer Yanez's wrongdoing. Thousands protested against the acquittal, the latest in a string of police shootings. One tally by an American media outlet says 963 people were fatally shot by police officers last year in the United States. Protesters and activists vow they'll continue to demand change. Paul Chaderjian, Al Jazeera.